Good evening. Good evening, everyone. Welcome. Welcome to St. Mary Magdalene Church. It's a privilege and a pleasure to be able to welcome you into all the grim December evening. But we're getting close to Christmas. The Christmas trees around remind us of that. For those of you that I haven't met before, my name is Chris Lyon. I'm the rector of the church, newly installed about 7 weeks ago or so. So still relatively new to the area and new to the church. It's a privilege and a pleasure to be able to welcome you this evening. I'm particularly delighted to welcome you for this service in support of what really seems like a very special charity. It's not something that I've come across before in other places particularly, but had a bit of a look at the work that the charity does this afternoon. Just wonderful to see such a valuable service being provided to the local community, a way to support and help young people in a time of great need. I'm sure that there are a variety of us here this evening, you know, those of us who are here are supporters, but perhaps those of us who have been bereaved. And wherever you are this evening, my prayer and my hope is that you just find this time together a blessing for all of us. So as we begin our service, let's take a moment to pray. Father, we thank you for this time that we have together this evening. As we gather to support the work of the Children's Bereavement Centre, we pray for your blessing on all who work as part of the charity. Would you continue to guide them and fill them with your love and compassion? And we pray too for any who are here this evening who have been bereaved and may be grieving. Just as you yourself wept when your friend Lazarus died, would you help each one of us to process our grief, recognizing it as a natural response to loss? And would you give us your comfort and your peace? In Jesus' name.
Good evening. My name is Amy Cabot and I'm one of the trustees at the Children's Bereavement Centre. Unfortunately, Kate Baxter was unable to attend the service this evening and has asked me to say a few words in her place. On behalf of everybody at the Children's Bereavement Centre, we would like to welcome you all to our Candlelight service. Despite these turbulent times, we are so pleased to be able to once again join together in person for a service in this beautiful setting to reflect and remember those we love who are sadly no longer with us. Over the past 2 years, the loss of a loved one has posed even more difficulties due to all the restrictions that have been in place. The Children's Bereavement Centre staff and volunteers have continued to work throughout to offer support and advice to those who have needed it. Although it was challenging not being able to be with you face to face this last year, and we all realise how important that is, we hope we still managed to support you in the best way that we could. We realise how difficult it can be for those grieving to reach out during a painful and difficult time, and the courage it takes to pick up the phone and ask for help and support. We are in awe of the bravery you have shown in being able to ask for help, and acknowledge that all of you, parents, carers, young people, children, have shown this courage. It has never been more important to ensure that the message "it's good to talk" is out there and for us all to support each other. Christmas is always a difficult time to cope with grief. We sometimes think that we should be celebrating and having a good time. But the people we have lost would not want us not to enjoy this magical time of year with our children and our families. We hope this service gives you time to reflect, acknowledge your loss, and move forward to Christmas with joy and love. Some of the singers and performers taking part tonight are service users, and we would like to thank them for being part of this special service. If you feel the need to applaud, and I've practiced out there, we absolutely should, their performances, then please do, because you'll agree with me, they really deserve it. And now it's my pleasure to introduce Barney Rhodes Academy Chamber Choir, who will sing "Remember Me".
Thank you.
remember their kindness, their goodness, their will. So blow little candles up briefly. You'll know that their memory can't die as you see their sweet faces in the glowing. Shed a tear, say a prayer, and then goodbye.
Mary Cook,
Matthew Henry Finn Cooper, Beth Cotter, Jane Cowling, Janice Delvin, Phil Dawes, William DeBoe, Philip Jewett, Gail Dixon, Bert Douglas, Marjorie Douglas, Thea Douglas, Joan Jerez, Robert Dyer, Betty Fenton, Margaret Foster, Harry Gadd, Hilda Gadd, Sandy Gaffer, Reg Glaister, Jean Glaister, Molly Gillespie, Jason Gillespie, Scott Graham, Joan Granger, David Gray, Vera Gray, Cliff Green, George Goombury, Keith Hart, Daniel Harris, Lewis Harris, Miriam Harris, Jeff Haywood, June Haywood, John Haywood, Mark Hitchcock, Sybil Holden, Sarah Holland, Stephen Hughes, known as Acker, Betty Hunt, Peter Hunt, Trevor Innes, Joan King, Alison Lacey, Megan Lacey, Steve Littler, Tracy McLeod, Marion Marsden, Julian Marshall, Andrew McCullough, Ben Nellis, Tricia Menzies, Richard Mayer, John Wilkes, Catherine Mortimer, Cynthia Mosdale, Francis Mosdale, Ron Mosdale, Benny Nelson, Josie Nelson, Steve Nelson, Tracy Nelson, Jane Louise Overland, Catherine Parker, Maureen Patrick, Andrew Perrott, Carmen Coxon, Alicia Faye Price, Tony Price, Andrew Bradford, Dennis Bradford, Kim Raffles, Paul Rear, Marjorie Rees, Jan Cholo, Ray Shaw, Ken Shaw, Vera Shaw, Joseph Shaw, James Shepherd, Kevin Shepherd, Teresa Sipsey, Betty Smith, Raymond Smith, Terry and Veronica Stevenson, Austin James Bird Spindley, Alistair Sykes, Dale Taylor, John Taylor, Jean and Eddie Taylor, Cyril Turl, Sam Turl, Anne Barber, Tracy Walsh, Andrew Warren Lewis, Terence Wilson, Jack Winkett, Linda Woolley, Olivia Ashley Wood. We will now have a minute's silence.
Let us pray. Loving Father, as we have taken this time to remember our loved ones who we have lost, we ask again that you would comfort us in our grief. We thank you that in you we have a God who is not aloof, but who knows what it is to suffer loss and separation. And we thank you too that you have given us this glorious hope that one day all who put their trust in you will be reunited in your kingdom, where there will be no more suffering, or mourning, or crying, or pain.
Powerful when performing passes, locked from eye to eye.
Raw and red when filled with tears, hollow when torn in grief. Dancing, playing when in love, wide-eyed in disbelief.
Okay, so I wrote this song after I volunteereded for the bereavement weekend away, and came back, and the first thing I did was grab my guitar. Didn't realise how difficult it was going to be with the children. You see all the emotions and the grief and that. And I got home and this song has appeared. I hold on to your love like a sharp jagged stone, and it cuts through my flesh and gets right through my bones. 'Cause I know you're no longer coming home anymore. And if wishes were flowers, you know I'd plant a million roses, 'cause you are the one who I miss the most. And if you could only one more time walk back through the door, 'cause you live to raise me and life's right to erase you from me, but it failed. And I'll never forget you, come in rain or hail. Hail, hail, hail down on me. And I'll 10,000 wishes, and I'm so lost now, now never come true. And as I cry to the heavens, here comes the rain, 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 but a rainbow of peace. Ooh, ooh, a rainbow of peace. Carry your name like a sweet melody, 'cause I know that your love brings the best out of me. And you'll always be more than just a memory to me. Like the time we got lost in the woods, you and I, oh, we built that old den down there, touched the sky. And you fought for my love so much you died a thousand times. 'Cause you lived to raise me, and life tried to erase you from me, but it failed. And I'll never forget you, come in rain or hail. Hail, hail, hail down on me. And I'll 10,000 wishes, and I'm so lost now, that'll never come true. And as I cry out to the heavens, here comes the rain, 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 but a rainbow appears.
Set in the Christmas table for the people who have died to remember them. Sing family holly. Get in presents, eating food. On Christmas Eve we have a big dinner and Mummy and Daddy play with us on Christmas Day. We have presents and sacks on Christmas morning, we open those in our parents' room. I remember going to the Christmas market with my mum before she died, buying bubble hats. The excitement going to bed on Christmas Eve on Christmas Day, some of her 11 gifts in my stocking. Before my special person died, we used to go out and play on Christmas Eve, eating cookies and cupcakes, making a special bauble in memory of my special person and putting it on the tree at Christmas. All the family getting together.
lighting a candle in memory on Christmas morning before opening our presents.
What a wonderful, wonderful service. Thank you so much. I know Rachel's going to say thank yous of her own in just a moment, but I wanted to say thank you from me and on behalf of the church to all who have been a part of making this happen, to all who have contributed in various ways through singing, through reading and so on, to all who put the service together, and of course to all of you for coming along. I hope that you have found it a helpful time as we've shared this time together. It's been a beautiful occasion. As we come to the end, let's pray for God's blessing. Neither death nor life can separate us from the love of God in Jesus Christ our Lord. Grant to us, Lord God, to trust you not for ourselves alone, but also for those whom we love, and who are hidden from us by the shadow of death. That as we believe your power to raise our Lord Jesus Christ from the dead, so may we trust your love to give eternal life to all who believe in him. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you always. Amen.